Hello YouTube, this is Vacuum Addict today, and today we have the invasion of the
Vaxes.
The Vax Mac here. As you can see, if I can, anybody can recall the red one that we got, this one here, from the boot sale.
I sent the whistling noise of the motor.
It's making a bit of a whistling noise. I've tried loads of things to cure it, and it's not seems to be doing much of it. But, move aside to the ones we won't actually show today. We have an orange one, which is the Mac Air 1. That is a Mac Air 2. And that is a Air Pet, which primarily are all three the same machine.
Fine, I took the shells out of this one, but I did that one, that's
right. Right, so we're going to put that back. Yes.
What's
sounding
on YouTube?
Well, the aim is that Carl's adamant on keeping this one in the middle, the Mac Air 2. This one's got some damage to it. This one's in absolutely mint condition. So anyway, this is the other Mac Air we've got, and this is the Mac Air Pet, or the Vax Air Pet. It is slightly different. It has got a hose here, while the other ones is around the back. It's got like a slider function on here. I don't know how old it is. It looks practically brand new. And the interesting thing is, the man who delivers the parcels to us a lot, and we do get a lot of large items to the door. Not as much as Ibaziac, I should imagine, but we've got a few of them. He actually gave these two to us for free, these two Mac Airs. He said that one of the customers that there was to, Adam, just literally chucking them away. On the Sunday, come in with the two Vaxes. And overall, like I say, he said this one's practically brand new, and it is, as you can see, very, very good condition indeed. So that's a free vacuum.
What?
And that's a free vacuum. So what we're going to do now, we're going to fire this one up. Because this one we think's got motor problems.
Yeah.
But this one might be slowing, so we might be binning both of these actually. So we'll have to see what happens. So we'll fire this one up first. You want to go and plug him in?
I'll do it.
Good boy.
Let me press the button down, I could go the hallway. And we suppose.
As you can see there, that's a bit that's damaged on it. And also the little clip that holds the hose in at the bottom, that's missing as well.
I'll plug it in the hallway.
So me personally, I'd think really I could buy maybe a hose for it.
Go!
So we'll just give this a test run. There's nothing wrong with it. He reckons the motor's slowing on it. We put a filter in it to obviously safeguard the motor. Get my hand out of the way. This one as well, look. The actual handle stays in place. See, this is why I think it's better to keep this one.
Put it on.
It's not tracking my view, isn't it? See, it's alright. Yeah, I think we should keep this one. Because for a couple of parts, just nicking the hose off this. This one here. We'll get to this one now. Well, back to this one now. This is the other one we got from the boot sale. This one whistles.
Go.
I've tried ripping the seals off.
I'm going to push it.
Every trick I know, trying it still does it occasionally.
I'm going to push it.
This doesn't sound well, that one. And that's got the filter back in, isn't it?
Yeah.
See, that one don't sound very well at all.
Yeah.
That one sounds better. And, a little test run of this one. Look, the handle bit here.
Don't stay up.
Doesn't stay up either. I mean, like I say, I personally would keep the orange one. It's only a hose on. I mean, it is an animal or whatever, but you end up returning to the written one.
push it down.
It's not sounding very well, and it looks like somebody's had it apart because one of the Carl's pointing out one of the screws is missing.
Why? The one that goes into the mold too.
Yeah. So I think we should just chuck that red one away. Take the hose part off it. And fix the orange one. This one is absolutely stunning. This one. It will clean up really, really well. This one.
Oops, it tore the saw.
This one has the thinner cable. This reminds me of the old DC05 cable. Like the flat ones. The ones.
Go. This one is shipped in carpet.
It's got a very cheap flex.
This one's shipped in carpet.
This one's very good.
Here it go. What does that sound like?
Sounds a little sharp, isn't it? Yeah, and you've got like a... I'm going to just... Yeah, you're not on too much. No, that's the hard floor to make.
I've just shown you how to go.
That's not look. That's perfect. So it does stick. Quite an impressive machine, actually. That's what it should be like. So that one runs as it should do.
And it's not got the brand new smell to it.
And it has got the brand new smell to it.
Look.
So who's done that?
The Hoover.
The Vax did it. Oh yeah, we didn't worry about that. Like you say, that rug has been chomped by the sharks. It's been chomped up lots of things. I mean, anything's going to rip that off anyway. Anything with a bit of suction is going to pull it off. So, yeah, so I think from... Carl wants to keep the red one. I still think we should keep the orange one and bin that one because it's so much things wrong with it. I mean, at the end of the day, all right, we paid £9 for that, but we got these two for free. And I think the orange one does look a bit nicer because it is the classic Vax orange, isn't it?
Yeah.
And I think Vax are celebrating their 40 years of innovation as well this year, so...
You've got a purple
wrap
like that now.
Yeah, so...
Nice purple one, it's all
so
purple.
So I think generally, like you say, we'll keep this one. We'll clean that one up. That one can go in the trash.
Today.
Well, we'll just have to take the good bits off. We'll keep the filters and stuff for spares.
Keep And keep the hose.
Yeah, that's the bit we need off it, really.
Why? No, and it's got the red.
It don't matter, you can't see that red bit down there.
So,
there's
another problem on this one.
Yeah, but it stays in. Yeah.
The kit's missing.
Yeah. I mean, more likely we'll come across another Mac Air. I mean, like I say, that one is the original Mac Air.
Tell me what year that's coming in socks.
I don't know. I can't remember.
2002.
I know a few.
That's near.
I know a few of the viewers always say this is the worst vacuum they've ever bought. It doesn't perform after. It doesn't perform as well as it was when it was new. Things like that. So yeah, I think we'll keep the orange one. And we're going to keep that one, and that one's going to go in the trash. Something's going on wrong with it. Like I say, it's only a cheap... it is made in the Republic of China, and I think they use very cheap parts. It's amazing, really. They gave them a 6-year guarantee of them, really. Because I don't... Like you say, I don't think that one's even 6 years old, and that one certainly isn't 6 years old. I must admit, Vax must pay out a lot of money on repairs and spares.
Why did... This part's not coming off the sun.
Isn't it? Oh, I'll sort that in a minute. So what do you say now, Carl?
I'll
probably give it a light clean on this one.
And it looks like in the rest barrel on that one.
Alright, bye for now.